Mas madali kasing magbenta ng insurance product quickly, mas mahirap to sell the right way. Hi! Getting ready with the Financial Beshi? Hello, Nicole, my makeup artist in ANC. Okay, makikinig muna siya habang nagkukurso tayo about insurance because mag-start ng business outlook in a bit. So, sabayan nyo kaming dalawa habang kami nagpe-prepare. Alam mo ako, lagi akong nare-recruit, Nicole, di ba? Ang dami nang nag-recruit sa akin since I started my career. So, might as well find out kung totoo ang chismis. So, I talked to Jojo Bungkayo, also known as George Bungkayo, the legendary. He has been in the insurance industry for 30 years. Maraming pinagdaanan si Jojo sa kanyang journey, and I'll tell you all about that in a little bit. But, take note that at the moment, meron na siyang sarili niyang agency in Prulife UK. It's called Jasper Financial General Insurance with 2 branches, one in Quezon City and another one in Batangas, where Nicole comes from.
Yeah, Batangas.
What is it with Pru that encourages that kind of earning?
Alam mo, in any company naman, you can do that, I think. But I think what is unique with Pru is yung expertise niya in growing your agency. I still believe that it's the number one on that aspect. You're gonna find agency leaders who have 3,000-4,000 agents under him. That's already a company by itself.
Oo nga.
You'll find agencies here that whose production is bigger than an average life insurance company. So you can just imagine how much will the people or the management team of that agency earns.
Eto ka, sabi ni Jojo, kung ang habol mo lang ay pera, you might make it 1 or 2 years. Pero, mas madali kasing magbenta ng insurance product quickly, mas mahirap to sell the right way.
When I entered the room of my prospect, you're gonna tell me, okay, do you have all the papers that I'll be signing? I have a check already. Sabi ko, can we talk about it before you sign? Almost all of them are like that in different various degrees. Because when I go into that prospect and I will tell them, let's talk about it, let's do a financial need analysis, and then they're gonna tell me, no, because you don't have to do that. I have a budget already because Auntie Lou will be mad at me if I won't go and buy from you. Because those prospects are all relatives and my mom will call them that Jojo will come to your office and be ready with your check.
So what a nice mom.
So I did not learn how to sell.
Very interesting. A lot of people do it the opposite.
No, probably I'm lucky.
Okay, very important ang brand sa pagbebenta ng insurance, especially if you're selling to high net worth clients, which Jojo is actually doing. Kasi yung mga business owners, yung mararami ng pera, syempre they're very particular who they deal with. And Prulife actually daw provides a lot of tools so that its insurance agents are very successful.
It's because when we were starting in Pru, nobody knows Pru. We're Prudential talaga, PLC. We came from UK. Alam mo yung Titanic? Ganon, magkukwento ka ng ganon. Kasi they don't really know. Eh, bakit po like UK? Eh, kasi sa Pilipinas, ang dami ng Prudential. May Prudential Guarantee by the Cuyuto Family. It's a non-life thing. May Prudential Bakery. May Prudential Funeral Parlor. So, everybody loves Prudential. So, we put on Prulife. So, but why is it that we grew from there? If the brand is number one of importance. Again, it's important. Dapat given na siya. Dapat you have to use that brand that Pru was able to establish through the years. Kasi you have the backing of a very well-known brand already.
I have heard this from all of the insurance CEOs that I've interviewed as a journalist. Ang dami na nila na interview ko. To be a top earner, kailangan mataas ang rejection quotient mo. Hindi lang sipagan, hindi lang damihan ng pagbenta. Kailangan alam mo yung hindi ka masyadong maduduro pag nasinzone ka kahit ng best friend mo. Kumusta ka pag nasisinzone ka, Nicole?
Okay.
Ayan, dapat walang ganyan sa business na ito.
This business is simple but it's not easy. It's simple, you just have to do the activities. But it's not easy because when you get those, all the rejection, wow, this is my best friend. And now, sinzone lang ako sa kanya because he knows that I'm in insurance. So If you can hack it, then you're gonna be able to make it. You want to earn big money? Yes. So if you want to earn big money, don't sell life insurance. And he was shocked. I mean, yeah, I thought insurance is good. No, if you want to earn big money, don't sell life insurance. Sell what it can do. So there are various concepts there, like liquidity requirements, income continuity. Probably I'm lucky. So I went into that. I was somehow ridiculed by the anbantao sa kanila, mga medrep, no? Kasi they were there for some reason. Medrep are not, they don't have an office in their building. They're always up. Even their supervisor, I think, ang tawag sa kanila, district managers, yung supervisors. Wala yung office. But for some reason that day, they were there in the lobby. And the lobby of that pharma is like a hotel. Ang ganda lang doon sila. So when I came in with the next client and everything, sabi niya, bago ka ba? Sabi niya, no. So you're not with us? No. Ganun. Ano ka? Sabi ng iba, so baka supplier. tinanong yung company ko. When I mentioned the company, you know what? Parang ang tawag doon, parang choreograph, no? Parang parting of the Red Sea. Gumanon sila. Ay, insurance! That's one thing that I teach people, that, you know, we have to be humble, but we have to be dignified. It's not dignified for you to wait for someone because you're just a salesperson. Or to continue talking while the other guy is on the cell phone or in the laptop, or, you know, start to entertain some other people.
I
think you're too busy right now. And would you mind if we reset this? You have to believe that what you sell is of utmost necessity and importance of value to the person you're selling with. Because if you have doubt, no, of in, or you're propelled more on I'll be earning so much, I tell you, won't last, because the market is cruel. The it's not always mabait. So when you get those rejections, those very frank, you know, objections in the legs, but if you honestly, sincerely believe that it is something of great value to the person you're talking to, and sure, you're gonna earn, sure, but that is little to compared to what they're gonna be getting, then you're gonna be emboldened, empowered, and you have that confidence when you talk to anybody, because, you know, it's malaki yung kita niya. You have to be comfortable with that market segment that you are trying to get into. So, like, if you want to go to the high-end market, it will happen by progression. Now, dahil people at certain level would want to interact, or we want to talk with, you know, people who are also there or very much related to them. So,
do you think an agent na nagsisimula pa lang na walang contact na mayaman can make it big in the industry?
If you're a rank and file, then when you join, then I'm sure you're comfortable with people in that level, or probably up to supervisor, then you practice there because you're comfortable. Natural yung pagtaas ng ng confidence, kasi mag-iiba ng nakabili ka na ng bagong kotse, so medyo mayabang ka na ng konti. Parang ganoon, ha? It will be a natural progress. Huwag pipilitin unless you are very closely related to that contact. I remember this guy when I was starting, and I was trying to be mentored by that guy. He's an agency leader from another company too. And he was saying, you know, Joe, it's just an acre of diamond. So what's an acre of diamond? You know, people would like to have their own gold mine, sabi niya, but I would go for a diamond mine. So you've got to have an acre, parang hectares of diamond. And you know what? Your acre of diamond is just in front of you. And what would that be? As I said, if I'm a rock and fall, that's my acre of diamond. Yung mga kakilala ko, yung mga classmate ko. Huwag muna ako maghanap ng mga diamond sa iba. So this guy whom he hired, no, knock on his office and applying for an insurance agent position during our time, and he cannot find any thing that will justify him admitting that person. That person came from Cebu, doesn't speak much Tagalog, bagong salta sa Manila, walang contact. But sabi niya, nakaspot siya ng Acre of Diamond. And what is that? Sabi niya, saan ka tumutuloy dito sa Manila? Looking for opportunity with your family. Sa pinsan ko po. Oh, so anong business or work ng pinsan mo? He's a pilot, a captain. That's the Acre of Diamond. So he was able to sell to that pinsan 50,000 premium. At the time is big. And then get into the other pilots. And eventually, at the time, eventually, nakuha niya na siya yung name. Whether pilot or FAs, no, flight attendant. So umaman siya ron, TOT at that, nakapagtayo siya ng sariling agency. To a point na, ano pa bang pwede mong i-service sa amin? Sabi ng Palaya, sabi ng Pilots Association and the Employees Association. Alam mo, every year, ito yung binabayaran namin sa mga uniform. Gusto mo, ikaw na yung gumawa. So, gumawa pa siya ng sariling tailoring for the uniform.
Kaya naman, Jojo keeps busy by giving back through Gawad Kalinga Foundation, starting to 2 to 3 more businesses. Ang gusto niya mangyari sa kanyang dream board para makapag-provide ng livelihood to Filipinos. And from time to time, medyo nabubudol din si Sir ng mga sports cars. Pero sabi niya parang huwag masyado kasi hindi in keeping with his advocacy. Sabi niya, gusto niya daw mag-invest in club shares. Mas maganda daw yun kasi sa stock market, mas malaki ang kita at hindi pa volatile pa, di ba? Pero bawas daw siya sa sports cars because hindi nga in keeping with his advocacy. So, there you go mga beshes. If you feel that starting a career in insurance is for you, you can make it big. But choose the right company. Make sure that it fits your values and your own personal branding. You train yourself to take rejection well, sipagan, strategize, at work really hard. See you next time.